It's the year 1494, and you're in Milan, inside the refectory of the Church of Santa Maria delle Grazie. After studying other paintings of the Last Supper with Christ and the Apostles, and working out your composition, you're ready to start the work that the Duke of Milan has commissioned from you. Now, come close to the wall. Leonardo made notes in some of the manuscripts about the dimensions and proportions of the wall. Then he started imagining the scene along with each of the main characters. Folio 55R of the Codex Forester 3 contains Leonardo's first comment about the wall on which he was going to paint. It is 14 braccia, about 8 meters or 26 feet wide. Folios 3R, 62V, and 63R from the Codex Forester 2 contain notes about Christ and the Apostles. The characters are either described through their action, one drinks, another points, or by referring to people who could be used as their models. Leonardo carefully planned the composition and physiognomy of the Apostles and made many preparatory drawings. You're ready. Build some scaffolding from which to work. Prepare the wall with rosin, mastic, and gesso as a base for the oil and tempera paint you're going to use. Determine the central point of the linear perspective grid and hammer a nail into the wall. Use cords to form straight lines from the center of the perspective grid outwards. Trace the perspective lines that delineate the room to be painted. Now you can start the composition. Use preparatory cartoons to plan the layout of the painting. No trace of such drawings have survived, but this was the traditional method used in the Renaissance. One complete cartoon can be used to create the preparatory drawing. This method was commonly used for very large frescoes. Punch the cartoon with holes and use dark powder to trace the drawing onto the wall. Remove the preparatory cartoon to reveal the underlying drawing. To paint the upper lunettes, climb onto the scaffolding. Paint the three Sforza family coats of arms. We used a parchment from 1498 to reconstruct all the upper lunettes. Paint the blue background of the lunettes. Paint the vegetable garlands around the coats of arms. Paint the stars, the bands, and the gilded letters. Add the pieces of fabric and the snake to the central coat of arms. Paint the part that represents the ceiling of the painted room. Paint the walls of the room. Paint the floor underneath the table. Paint the eight tapestries on the side walls. Paint the three doors and the three windows between the tapestries. Paint the background landscape as seen through the two windows and the doorway. Paint the table and the tablecloth. Paint the 21 plates and the three serving trays on the table. Paint the 13 glasses of wine and the three jugs on the table. Note the absence of the chalice. Paint the bread rolls, the fruit, and the fish. Paint the Apostle Bartholomew. Paint the Apostle Peter. Paint Peter's bent arm with the knife. Paint the Apostle Matthew. Paint the Apostle James the Greeter. Paint the Apostle Philip. Paint the Apostle Andrew. Paint the Apostle Jude Thaddeus. Paint the Apostle James the Lesser. Paint the Apostle Simon the Zealot. Paint the Apostle Thomas. Paint the Apostle John. Paint the Apostle Judas, the traitor. Paint Judas's money bag and the fallen salt cellar. Paint Christ. The painting is complete. Now draw the halos. Wait, there aren't any halos. Leonardo never painted them, and no one ever added them later out of respect for the painting. Indeed, Leonardo thought of these 13 characters as people. While the patrons would certainly have considered this to be scandalous, they could not reject Leonardo's masterpiece. In fact, this is the true secret behind The Last Supper, that Leonardo wanted to represent people. people like us.